Today, I'll be demonstrating how to set up and use the WebHMI function on the Power Focus 6000 controller from Atlas Copco. This will allow us to have full control of the controller without having to be near the unit. The first step is to connect the Power Focus controller to the network. After opening the controller faceplate, we can directly connect the controller to the router or network switch through the labeled Ethernet port. There is an additional service Ethernet port below the controller, which isn't used for the WebHMI. Once connected, power on the controller and navigate to the settings page. The first tab that is open is the network tab. On the right side of the screen, there is a box which says Factory Ethernet Port. This is the Ethernet port inside the controller. The first option lets you select between manual and DHCP. If your network administrator has a specific static IP that the controller must be assigned to, this is where you will enter it. Be careful not to select an IP address that is already in use on your network, or you won't be able to connect to the controller. If you aren't sure what IP address to assign, select the DHCP option. This will automatically assign an IP address, subnet mask, and gateway to your controller that is available for use. The controller will quickly display the new information. Once you have the IP address of your controller, the rest is easy. Simply open up the internet browser on your phone, tablet, computer, or laptop that is connected to the same network, and enter in the address exactly as it's displayed on the controller. You can be connected to the network through an Ethernet cable or through Wi-Fi. Both will work. Upon connecting, you will see the Atlas Copco logo and a progress bar as the WebHMI connects your device to the controller. After a few seconds, you will see an exact copy of your controller user interface. You now have full control and access to the controller, as if you were right in front of it. Any changes made will update in real time on the controller. You can modify presets, view results in live tightening data, even update the controller software from a file on your computer without needing to load it to a USB stick. That's how easy it is to access the WebHMI function on the new Power Focus 6000. For more information, and to purchase your own, please visit the link in the description. If you'd like to see more tutorials on the Power Focus 6000, be sure to subscribe and enable alerts so you never miss a new video from Flexible Assembly. Thanks for watching.